Hello friends, welcome back to Center for Civil Engineers. In this video, I am going to explain how to determine volume of earthwork in case of railway embankment. The main reason to calculate this volume is, first thing, to make payments to the contractors, and another thing, second one is, to procure the materials. In the process of construction, we need soil. As per given drawing, if you want to make the embankment section, we need total quantity of soil. If you want to calculate total quantity, we need drawing, and also we need ground levels. How much formation level is there and what are the ground levels are available on the site. Based upon that, we are going to calculate the quantity of cutting area and the filling area. Generally, while fixing formation level, we used to fix the formation level in such a way that the cutting area and filling area should be equal. Then only it is possible to construct your road work or embankment work, anything in a economical way. Otherwise, it involves more money if you borrow soil from other place. So watch this video from starting to ending so that you can learn how to calculate volume of earthwork in case of filling and cutting. So while it, let's get into the video. The problem which I want to explain now, volume of earthwork for railway embankment. Let me read it for you. A railway embankment of formation width of 8 meter and 2:1 side slope is to be considered. The ground level along the center line is as follows. Here there are two values given, chainage values and ground level values. Chainage values given at an interval of 50 meters. And then corresponding ground levels at all chainages also given in the second row. Then the embankment has a rising gradient of 1:100 and the formation level at zero chainage is 115 meter. Assume the ground is level across the center line. Determine the volume of earthwork. Let us see how to determine this problem. See, first observe the given data. First one is formation width is given and side slope given, and another data, chainage given and ground level given, and importantly rising gradient given 1:100 and formation level FL is given at a 0 meter chainage. Let me draw the cross section of this embankment here. Here you can see the cross section of this embankment. This is the cross section of embankment. The formation width nothing but this width 8 meter and side slope is 2:1, that is S:1. This is the diagram of this is cross section of embankment. Now other let me write this complete information over here. Solution, first data is given, formation width denoted by small b is equal to 8 meter and side slope is equal to 2:1. Here 2:1 nothing but S is equal to 2. Then another data, rising gradient given, that is 1:100. I'll draw the diagram what is the meaning of 1:100 and how to calculate this formation levels with the help of this rising gradient. Next, formation level at chainage is given, FL at 0 meter is equal to, that is starting point, 0 chainage is 115 meter given. This is a given data. With the help of this given data, we can calculate the total volume of earthwork. Now here you can see the tabular form. In this tabular form, I am going to calculate the formation level values and cutting and filling values. Okay, let me see. Already I have mentioned here 0 meter, 50 meter, all chain edges. Here 250 also there, 250 meter, and at the 250 meter the ground level is 118.25 118.25 meter is there. Then next, at a zero chain edge, this FL is given. FL nothing but formation level. Formation level, this is ground level. Ground level. Okay, we'll calculate how to get all these values. Let me write first value. First value is 115. It is given in the problem, 115 meters. Then simple, by subtracting ground level minus formation level, you will get positive, negative. Based upon the values we have, we are going to get, based on that we'll get cutting and filling. Now from this also I am going to explain clearly for easy understanding. Actually, if you visualize the actual shape of the embankment which we have given, see, this is the actual diagram. It would be like this. This is actual total length of this embankment is 250 meter. Here you can see 250 meter. This is isometric view of this embankment. Okay, for example, say this is 0 meter. Here we have 50 meter, 100 meter, 150 meter, and 200 meter. This is 100, 150, 200, 250. Like this, we have embankment section up to the 250 meters. And at all, this formation width is given 8 meter, and side slopes 1 is given. Like this, section is given, and side slope given, and also longitudinal slope is given. Okay, and also longitudinal slope is given, that is and also rising gradient is given. Rising gradient is equal to 1 in 100. That means if you take 100 meter horizontal, that this is horizontal, this is vertical. Okay, if you take 1 meter vertical and horizontal 100 meter, how much rising gradient is available? For example, this is 0, say this is 50, 100, 150, like that. If you draw lines like this, whatever we are going to get, this ordinate, this is offset, that we have to calculate. Okay, this is the meaning of 1 in 100. For every 1 meter of vertical distance, for 100 meter length, these are the magnitude values. But it is given for 1 in 100, but our actual length is 250 meter. If it is 250 meter, how much the rising at each point, at each interval, that is at a 0 meter how much rising, at 100 meter how much rising, and 150 meters, like that we have to calculate the rising values. Okay, simple. Then coming to this picture, here you can see the points over here. This is actual cutting and filling of the values. Cutting and filling values, here you can observe here. Let me show you. This is 0 meter and here 50 meter and here 100 meter. At this section A4 150 meter, at this point 200 meter, last one is 250 meter. These are the chain edges, that means distances 0, 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, like that we have 5 chain edges. Okay, all these we have mentioned over here, and these are the ground levels. All these ground levels given in the problem, and formation level given at a first point only. Okay, then simple, how can you get these formation levels? How can you get these formation levels? Simple, we have given rising gradient. How much rising gradient I am writing at the above? Rise per 50 meter. For every meter, how much? For every 50 meter, how much rising value is there? That is, raised height is there. That we have to calculate. Simple, 50 divided by 100. That is equal to 0.5 meter. Okay. What is, how much interval is there between these two? All the distance, the change of interval is 50 meter. That's why 50, it is given 1 in 100. Na? That's why we have to divide with 100. 50 divided by 100, this gives you 0.5 meter. That means at every 50 meter interval, that is here I have mentioned now, 0, 50, 100, 150, like that and so on. At 0, 0, at 50 meter will be having 0.5 meter increment. At 1 meter, 1, at 150 meter, 1.5. At 2 meter, at 200, at 200, 2 meter, at 250 meter will be having 2.5 meter rising gradient, like that. Okay, now just simply add 0.5 meter for the starting value. Okay, simple, at 150, up to 0 meter this is 115, no, formation level. At 50 meter 0.5 increases, that means 115.50. simple, 115.50, 116, and 116.50, and 117, and 117.50. that's all. What I have done, I have added 0.5 meter at every point, at every 50 meter. Why? Because rise value is at every 50 meter interval 0.5 going to increase. Okay, 0.5 meter is going to increase. Then now just subtract from ground levels. This ground level minus this value gives you 0.75. That is positive you are getting. This is higher value, this is lesser value. That's why we are getting positive. That positive nothing but cutting value. We are considering cutting nothing but removing the excess soil. For example, here you can see A1 nothing but we are removing this soil. That is means excess. We got excess soil at the formation level. Okay, if you want to make formation level, you have to remove it, and wherever we have excavated the soil, that soil we have to fill in the cutting portion. Then 114.35 minus 115.50. Next we are getting negative value, that is 1.15. okay, this next 116.80 minus 116.80 minus 116, that is 0.8. that is positive value. Why? Because this is higher, this is lesser value. Next one is difference of these two is 1.3 filling, and at 200 meter this is 1.5, and last one is again cutting, that is 0.75 meters. See, all these are also meter units. And coming to section nothing but this one. This is a section, this is A1 section, A2, A3 and so on up to A5. Okay, just to I am writing A1, A2, A3, A4, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and A6. Likewise, we are going to get all sections. After getting these sections, actually this is the isometric view. This is the isometric view, no? Isometric railway embankment, isometric section or isometric view of embankment. Now if you observe this diagram shows you where, which portion from 0 to 50 meter positive is cutting, negative is filling. Here, if you observe this one, first at a zero chain edge, we have 0.75 meter cutting. That means this height is, this portion is the cutting portion, positive value. And at section 2, you have this, at section 2, we have negative value, that is filling we have. This portion we have to fill. All these things we have to calculate now. This x first x1 value, x2 value, at what point it is going to change. Actually, this is 50 meter length. If it is 50, if this is x1, how much this value we have to calculate. Okay, that I am going to show you how to calculate. And at every section, this is A to up, this is section A, section 2, section 3, section 4, like that we have 6 sections up to last point, that is 250 meter. Okay, let me show you the calculation part of, then you can see calculation part. Yes, let me calculate x1. X1 divided by 0.75 is equal to 50 minus x1 by 1.15. okay, simple. From first portion I am taking these values, x1 by 0.75 is equal to 50 minus x1. This is the distance, distance minus known distance is 50 meter, and x1 we have to calculate. From this, simply from cross multiplication, 1.15x is equal to 37.5 minus of 0.75x, and from this x1 is equal to 19.74 meter. Likewise, we got x1. Similarly, calculate x2 value. X2 is equal to x2, actually for calculation of x2, x2 divided by 1.15 is equal to then 50 minus x2, x2 divided by 0.80. here x2 divided by 1.15, nothing but this section belongs to the second one. Okay, second one, this 50 is common interval, 50 minus x2, this is a common interval. Again, the cross multiplication again, 0.8 x2, this two, 0.80 x2 is equal to 57.5 minus of 1.15 x2. from this x2 is equal to 29.44 meter. Okay, likewise we got x2 value also. Similarly, x3 value, from for the x3, divided by 0.80 meter is equal to 50 minus x3 divided by 1.30. okay, again cross multiplication. See, all these values I am taking from previous diagram. I have mentioned cutting and filling diagram, now from that diagram only I am taking these values. Then coming to next cross multiplication, x3 into 1.3, that is equal to 1.30 x3 is equal to 1.3 x3 is equal to 40 minus 0.80 x3. from this x3 is equal to 19.05 meter. Okay, now we got x3 value also. Then x4 value, x4 is equal to simple again, x4 divided by 1.30 is equal to 50 minus x4 divided by 1.50. again cross multiplication, 1.50 x4 is equal to 65 minus of 1.30 x4. from this x4 will comes out with x4 is equal to 23.21 meter. Okay, likewise we have calculated all values, all x values, distances. Okay, after calculating all distances, next step is calculation of areas. We have trapezium section. For trapezium section we have to calculate all areas at all intervals. We have total length of embankment is 250 meter at each section, at 0 meter chain edge, at 50 meter, at 100 meter, at all sections we have to calculate area. Calculation of area by using formula is equal to A is equal to B plus SH into H. This is the formula we have to use to calculate the area of trapezoidal section, that is this section. Okay, embankment section area is this formula. B, you know, 8 meter and S is equal to 2 meter, and but at every section we have to calculate this value. First let me calculate A1, nothing but for A1 this B is equal to 8 meter plus S common, that is 2 meter, and H is equal to 0.75. This value I am taking from tabular form, 0.75 into 0.75, that is equal to 7.13 square meter. Next A2, 8 plus 2 into 1.15 into 1.15. From this you will get 11.85 square meter area. Similarly A3, 8 plus 2 into 0.80 into 0.80 is equal to 7.68 meter square, and A4 is equal to 8 plus 2 into 1.30 into 1.30 is equal to 13.78 square meter. Similarly A5 is equal to 8 plus 2 into 1.50 into 1.50, that is equal to 16.50 square meter. The last one, again 8 plus 2 into 0.75 into 0.75. These values, H values, we have calculated in the tabular form. Some values we got in cutting, some values we got in filling. Okay, all these are heights. At height at each chain edge, each section. Each section means A1, A2, A3, A4 and so on up to A6. Then this last area is 7.13 square meter. Likewise, we got area values at all six sections. Now, next last step is calculation of volume. Calculation of volume of earthwork. Simple, how can you get volume? Area into height of that particular section. Okay, first from chain edge, that is from distance 0 to 50 meter we have to calculate. Okay, in 0 to 50 meter we have some area cutting, some area filling. Like that's why we have to calculate first cutting area is equal to the distance is 7.13 plus 0 divided by 2 into 19.74. Okay, this is the x value. This is average of these two values divided by 2 into this x value distance, that is equal to 70.37 m cubic meter. And similarly filling value, filling is equal to, in filling again the zero nothing but the changed portion. See, this is 0 point. Okay, this is x value. okay. So this value nothing but this center one. First, this is cutting value. Cutting value we have to calculate. This cutting value, top one is cutting value. This positive and this is negative. And 0 plus 11.85 divided by 2 into 30.26. This is remaining portion. That how can you get this value? 50 minus this 19.74 gives you 30.26 is the distance. For the second portion, this one, that is 30.26. That comes out to be 179.29 m³. Okay, next B, from chain edge 50 to 100 meter. First, again filling is equal to 11.85 plus 0 divided by 2 into 29.49. That is comes out to 174.73 m³. And then cutting value is equal to 0 plus 7.68 divided by 2 into 20.21 is equal to 78.76 m³. This is second stretch, that means distance from 50 to 100. Next, C, from chain edge 100 to 150 meters, that is cutting. In 100 to 150 meter we have first cutting, that is 7.68 divided by plus 0 divided by 2 into 19.05 is equal to 73.15 m³. Similarly, filling is equal to 0 plus 13.78 by 2 into 30.95 is equal to 213.25 m³. Similarly, last next chain edge is from chain edge 150 to 200 meter. Here filling is equal to 13.78 plus 0 divided by 2 into 23.20, that is equal to 159.92 m³. Similarly, cutting quantity is equal to from 0 to 150 to 200, 0 plus 16.50 divided by 2 into 26.80, that is equal to 221.02 m³. Likewise, up to we got section 150 to 200 meter. Next, last one, from chain edge 200 to 250 meter. Okay, first one is only cutting we have. Last one, if you recollect figure, shape of the figure, cutting only we have. Cutting is equal to 16.50 plus 7.13 divided by 2. This is average height into this is distance 50. Okay, this total distance we are taking here. Why? Because we have only cutting. Cutting means the portion which is available below the formation level, that comes out to 590.75 m³. Now we got this chain edge, last chain edge, completely cutting portion. Now we have cutting value separately, filling value separately. Now I want to calculate separate filling value, separate cutting value. Now let me calculate total volume of cutting. Total cutting is equal to 70.37 plus 78.76 plus 73.15 plus 221.02 plus 590.75. That is equal to 1034.05 cubic meters. Then total filling volume is equal to 179.29 plus 174.73 plus 213.55 plus 159.92 plus 159.92. The up to last one. These are the filling values, only four values we have, and total filling value is equal to 727.19 m³. If you observe, cutting value is more, filling value is less. Actually, while fixing the formation level in such a way that we have cutting value is more, filling value is less. So there is no problem. Whatever we cut, that is enough to fill the filling area. Suppose if you get reversely, it is difficult to manage. We have to borrow soil or gravel from the other place. Automatically, the cost of construction will be increases. I hope you understood about all these things. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubts, you can ask in comment section. And those who are new to this channel, subscribe to this channel and also follow me in your favorite social media networks like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also tap our bell icon so that whenever I post a new video, you will get notification. Thank you.